So Microsoft Copilot is an interesting app that you may have heard about already. It's pretty much being talked about all over the world. And in today's video, I wanted to show you around it so that you know how to use it to boost your daily productivity, but also how to just learn AI in general. Like, how can you use it in a practical way? So we're going to explore it. And the great thing with this app is it's free to use and it doesn't have many limitations. And when you sign in, it gets even better. So let's dive into the app. The good thing is you can download it on iOS, Android, Mac, and Windows as well, and even access it on web with or without a Microsoft account. Although, as I mentioned, there are some limits. So how can you use this powerful AI system? Well, it's quite simple. There's a few basic ways that you can use it. And I want to start with the more unique one. The first way that you can use it is this feature called Daily. And it is a podcast feature that summarizes news from different sources around the world. Now, what's nice about this? You can basically skip through certain news stories that are provided by certain existing news parties, which mean essentially you get dictated versions of news articles condensed into a 5-minute podcast, which you can even skip. So incredibly helpful, as maybe even on the phone, on the tube, on wherever you may be, just learning about the latest news, but summarized in a really useful manner. So the second thing you can do is with the mobile device. If you point it at something on your desk, for example, maybe you're at somebody else's house and you want to impress them by knowing what vase they've got or what Ferrari they've got on their desk, and you're wanting to know that information, you can quickly scan over the image and get a brief of all of that via Copilot. Now, essentially this uses ChatGPT, so essentially it's part of the same system, but it allows you access to that information and allows you to scan anything from flowers all the way over products and even give you advice on things. Like, for example, if you've got a broken pipe in the house, maybe it will know what pipe that is and what it's connected to and give you some general advice. For example, the other day, I actually asked it about my car and what oil filter my exact car uses. I took some photos and it gave some recommendations. I wasn't able to fix it. I'm not able to fix it. I'm able to fix software stuff, but at the same time, I had a better idea of able to brief a mechanic on it potentially. So there are 4 modes that you can use inside of Copilot, and these are called voice modes, and you can choose from 4 voices and you can naturally get signed in. Now, if you're not signed in, you do get a limit. I think it's about 3 minutes. So just FYI, you don't have a limit that I found on the version when you're using the voice modes. And obviously it will use your history to be able to learn better about you. But you can pretty much ask it anything. You can have a conversation about how to improve your, hairstyle, for example. Not that I've had that conversation before, but you can also ask it and be able to get feedback on a speech that you're writing or absolutely anything really. So our 4th thing that you could use Copilot for in the app is generative AI. Now, it's not only going to help you compose emails better, but it can also do a lot of other things. For example, you could give it a draft to a speech that you're writing, or maybe even start to plan a trip that you may be thinking about, giving you locations and recommendations based on Bing search that allow you to scan the right things in the web and find the right recommendations that people have maybe blogged about or shared in the past. Now, this final feature is for those who have signed in on Copilot, and it's essentially a way for you to use Think Deeper, which is a new way to go deeper on a search. So here I could ask the Thinking Deeper model to essentially unpack a more complex thing. So I'm asking it whether it can plan a more complex trip for me and give me recommendations. So here it's given me a few recommendations on 5 places that I can stop by from Avellino to Amalfi, and I can start narrowing down my options with a quick reference table as well as useful sources. So Thinking Deeper, that is available when you sign in, is slightly longer and does take around 5 to 20 seconds on average to respond to you. So hopefully that gave you a better idea of how to use Copilot as an app. Now, this isn't part of Microsoft 365. This is its own separate app, but it is a much more compelling app for everyday users. Now, just before we move on and wrap up this video, there is something in settings called privacy, and this is important if you don't want your conversations to be trained using artificial intelligence. So you can switch and choose what's suitable for you in the settings. That's obviously something that is deeply personal to you. So today we learned about a few different things about Copilot. We learned about how you can use voice modes, how you can turn it into a podcast for every single morning, and how you can use it to plan trips. So Copilot is a powerful way for you to use your app every single day. It's free and accessible and uses some of the GPTs that you may know and love, but in a much more friendlier package. You can find the links to Copilot below if you are interested in it. And naturally, if you want to explore and come and subscribe to this channel for more AI insights and research, we've got this channel and a brand new channel that will be linked below. So thanks so much for stopping by. Please do make sure to subscribe and I'll talk to you all very soon. So folks, if you're interested in getting 3 new tools in your inbox every single week, I'm gonna send them to you. And they're ones that I think are new and noteworthy. So if you're interested in that, you can sign up to the newsletter below and discover 3 new tools every week. On with the video. So let's just pause here. If you're interested in being more productive at work with AI, you can download our free guide to it below. So do check it out in the link in the description.